Lafayette promised me a fleet beyond compare and a captain without peer. Instead, I find myself greeted by one old ship in a boy in costume.
I promise we are all you need, Admiral.
I doubt this very much, but beggars do not choose.
And the ships I require?
They are yours, provided we survive this.
What would you have me do?
Hold the bay while I engage the main fleet. Should any British ships dare approach, destroy them. They must be kept from Yorktown.
Is us. I only hope the Admiral's quick to return.
Enemy approaching!
All right, boys! Make ready for war! Looks like they're coming to say hello. Ready yourself!
Aye, aye!
We're down a ship! Take care!
Thank you.
We're down a ship! Take care!
Yeah!
that's all sunk. We're on our own now, sir. Oh, God. Where are our blasted reinforcements?
They will come. We must hold the bay until they do.
Oh, this is madness. You're alone and we're without reinforcements.
He's not really planning to board them, is he? Has he lost his mind? He's got to get us all killed. Bastard.
They say you took down that man of war all alone. Perhaps Lafayette did not exaggerate when he spoke of your abilities. As promised, my ships are yours to command. What do you require?
5 of them must enter New York's harbor flying British flags.
Wait, wait. I thought you might need some pirates killed or goods transported, and instead, you asked for us to, what, shell New York?
No. Of course not.
Ah.
Only part of it.
Explain yourself.
I mean to infiltrate Fort George, but it is too well guarded. Cannon fire will breach its walls and scatter its guards.
And a ship that flies the French flag could never get near it.
You understand, then?
Not at all. But a promise is a promise, even when made to a lunatic.
I will light a signal fire when it is time for you to attack.
Vous l'avez entendu. Récupérez leurs drapeaux qu'on puisse les accrocher. Allez, vite!
Hello, Connor. Welcome back.
Is everything in place?
Oui. Lafayette waits for you inside the tunnel beneath the city.
All their talk of liberty and equality, fall back into the old ways. It will depend greatly on who is chosen to lead them. A man of humble means who has worked to earn his place.
Connor, this tunnel will take you into the military district.
And the Admiral?
He waits for you to light the signal. And then the strike begins.
And we will be there as well.
Need to get inside the fort.
Charles.
Gone.
Come now. You cannot hope to match me, Connor. For all your skills, you are still but a boy, with so much left to learn.
Give me Lee!
Impossible. He... is the promise of a better future. The sheep need a shepherd.
He has been dismissed and censured. He can do nothing for you now.
A temporary setback. He will be restored.
You act as though you have some right to judge. To declare me and mine wrong for the world. And yet everything I've shown you, all I've said and done, should clearly demonstrate otherwise. Support the crown. We work to see this land united and at peace. Under our rule, all would be equal to the...
They offer freedom,
which I've told you time and time again is dangerous. There will never be consensus, son, amongst those you have...
Surrender, and I will spare you.
Brave words from a man about to die.
You fare no better.
Even when your kind appears to triumph, still we rise again. And do you know why? It's because the Order is born of a realization. We require no creed, no indoctrination by desperate old men. All we need is that the world be as it is. And this is why the Templars will never be destroyed.
Don't think I have any intention of caressing your cheek and saying I was wrong. I will not weep and wonder what might have been. I'm sure you understand. Still, I'm proud of you in a way. You've shown great conviction, strength, courage. All noble qualities. I should have killed you long ago. Well,
Onagiwa here, Ragini.
We've got a problem. Haytham doesn't have the amulet anymore.
But the temple's still sending data. There must be more to this story.
Only one way to find out.
My father is dead. Charles Lee now leads the Templar Order in his place. I see now why ours is an eternal war. For each piece taken from the board, another is placed upon it. Back and forth we go, across the world, across the ages. Some days mine feels an impossible task, but I cannot afford to be consumed with doubt. The people need me. Now more than ever. I must stop the Templars. I will kill Charles Lee.
We gather today to remember a man of fearless vision who sought to change the world. And change the world he did. Look around. Even now the British prepare to retreat. Their spirits broken. Their forces splintered. The Patriot leadership shall soon follow. Either into our service.
He sent me away, that day, at Fort George. He feared for my safety. I should have stayed. He said there was no danger.
He was wrong.
I will kill you, Connor. This I swear. Not here, though. Not today. No. First, I'll destroy all you hold dear. I'll burn that homestead of yours to the ground and roast the seven heads of your precious founding fathers in its flames. And when I've finished with them, all the rest will burn as well. Your merry band of assassins, the human refuse that lives on your land, your village and its people, all of it gone.
You can try, Charles. But as with all your schemes, this too will end in failure.
Get him on his feet. He will wait. He will watch. And then, when he's seen all his life's work brought to ruin, only then will I allow him to die. Take him away.
Not so bold now, are you, boy?
Thank you.
Where is Charles Lee gone?
The harbor. To catch a ferry.
I believe these men meet the requirements.
You believe incorrectly. They're sick and weak. We're looking to build an army, not fill an almshouse.
It would take months to get them into fighting shape. We don't have the time.
No. Please. We'll do anything you want. Anything. Only take us with you.
Quiet, well.
Your merchandise is useless to us.
Perhaps we should discuss this back in my cabin.
Thank you.
sorry to have disappointed.
As you should be. For us to have come all this way for nothing. Tell me now why I shouldn't have you thrown into the sea.
No need to be rash. Only give me a little more time. I'll scour the other ships if I must. I'm certain there are prisoners who will meet your needs.
Very well. You have 2 days.
Thank you.
Present yourself to the Green Dragon Tavern in Boston with the men you've chosen. We shall meet you there along with our master.
Mister, please, can you help me?
Need something, darling?
No.
Oh, rude.
Can I help you?
You know you can.
Pardon? Oh!
I do not like having my time wasted.
Stop that! Oh, don't make me call the guards!
Make a sound and you die.
What do you want? He's in the harbor, at the Long Pier, most likely. We heard what happened at the parade. Jarl's got all nervous, said he was leaving the country. I thought it was overreacting. I guess not. No!
Thank you.
You can't go in there!
There's been an accident!
Why do you persist? You put us down, we rise again. You end one plot, we forge another. You try so hard, but it always ends the same. Those who know you think you mad, and this is why. Even those men you sought to save have turned their backs on you. Yet you fight. You resist. Why?
Because no one else will.
Rough night, was it? He headed inland. Took a ferry up the Charles River.
I will need passage as well.
Of course. Only say the word.
Why would they leave this behind?
Long have we waited for you to return. You have done as we asked. You have succeeded.
No, I have failed. My people are gone, chased out by those who I thought would protect them.
It is a trade, a sacrifice, and not in vain. For you have found it.
This?
Now you must hide it, where none shall think to look. And then in time, what once was shall be again.
I do not understand.
Nor need you. Only do as we ask. Then you may do as you wish.
But what of my people?
You have saved this place, as was your people's purpose. And that matters most.
It is not enough.
It will never be enough. You strive for that which does not exist. Still, you have made a difference, and you will do so again. Remember, you must hide the amulet where none might find it.
I know where the key is.
Then let's go!
Guess this is it.
We're right behind you.
Moment of truth.
Yes. Come. Here, at last.
You know our story now. Of how we tried. Of how we failed. All our hopes extinguished. Save one. Your touch. A spark. A spark to save the world.
Wait! Do not touch the pedestal.
Minerva?
You. But how? You left. You destroyed the device.
Did you think there was only one?
What the hell is going on here?
You must not free her.
Free her?
Juno dwells within these walls, awaiting release. I will explain. While we worked to save the world, she sought instead to conquer it. She used our machines to set her plans in motion. Divination through numbers. There is a pattern to existence. To comprehend the calculations is to tame time. This was my focus. And so I built the eye to aid us. But she turned it towards her own ends. When we discovered her treachery, we put a stop to it. And then we left. But first we called to you, that you might try again. We thought it would be safe with her gone. Now I see we were deceived. She survived, she endured, and then she began to work. For centuries, Tinia and I walked the world, hoping to rekindle the spark of civilization. We shared what we knew as best we could. We were not the only ones, but for all the power we wrought, still death would claim us. But before it did, I would have one last look to know if we had succeeded.
That's how you're here now?
I had hoped you might find this place and finish our work. But it is too late. You and the Templars have squabbled over our refuse. You have wasted centuries, and so you have lost your chance. You cannot hope to stop the end now, Desmond. Only to survive.
She's lying! Only touch the pedestal, and the world will be saved.
Better the world burn than she be loosed upon it.
Is that so? Show him, then.
But he will not understand. It is complicated. It is...
Show me.
If you heed Minerva, the sun will have its way. The ground will crack and spit fire into the skies. All the world will burn. But this does not end the world, merely heralds its arrival. Darkness follows. Then you emerge, resolving to lay a foundation that such a tragedy does not befall the world again. You will become a symbol to those who survive. Hope, knowledge, determination. You will inspire them to rebuild, to thrive once more. And as the world heals, so too will humanity. But you are just a man, frail and mortal. You pass from the world, leaving behind only a memory. A legacy. You will be remembered first as a hero, later as a legend, and in time, as a god. It is the cruelest fate to have written words that meant well and see them made wicked and unwise. What was meant to encourage life, used instead to justify taking it. And so now you see that what was shall be again. So tell me, how is this better? She would sacrifice you, sacrifice the world, for no other reason than to deny me vindication.
They will enslave your kind, Desmond. Is this not why you fight? Is this not why you came here? To ensure more than just your race's future, but its freedom?
What future? What freedom? Billions dead and the whole cycle begun anew? This world has known nothing but heartache and horror since we left it.
Our gift to them, and you'd see it all returned.
Enough!
You must not do this.
Whatever Juno's planning, however terrible it might seem today, we'll find a way to stop it. But the alternative, what you want, there's no hope there.
If you free her, you'll be destroyed.
It will happen in an instant. There will be no pain.
You mustn't!
It's done, Minerva. The decision's made.
Then the consequences of this mistake are yours to live and die with.
You need to go. All of you. Now. Get as far away from here as you can.
Come with us! We'll find another way!
There isn't time.
Son.
You know it's true. It's already started. I need to do this now. So go. Go!
Some sort of global aurora borealis. Never seen anything like this before. Eyewitnesses describe electrical storms and erratic displays of unusual weather. Residents are being asked to remain inside and wait for... Geological surveys are now reporting seismic activity throughout the Ring of Fire. Northeastern Canada is said to be experiencing the largest... on record. Satellites and transformers are failing as the flare increases in intensity. Worldwide reports of blackouts and seems to be receding. Residual seismic and volcanic activity is being reported, but nothing approaching earlier levels. Obviously, it'll be a while before experts are able to assess the full extent of the damage caused by today's event. But it appears the worst is behind us. We'll be sure to bring you more as this story develops.
It is done. The world is saved. You played your part well, Desmond. But now it's time that I played mine.